Today, I'm covering 5 tips and tricks for Zwift workout mode that I use on a very regular basis that just might make your next workout on Zwift a more enjoyable experience. If erg mode and working hard could be called enjoyable. Let's get to it.
Starting off with tip number 1, and this is to show or hide the full workout graph on screen within the companion app. Now, if you've just missed what happened on screen, I'll do a reverse and an instant replay. Clicking here along the top will give you a visual representation of the entire workout that you're about to undertake. It will also give you a progress shadow as you complete the workout so you know where you're at, and I do find this better than a single progress line. Now, I'm not sure what the default is, but if you want to toggle that view either on or off to show or hide the workout specifics, that's how it works. On to tip number 2, and this is skipping the current interval and moving on to the next interval. And with the companion app, you can press and slide across and skip the current interval and move on to the next one. Again, instant replay of that. Press, slide across, and away we go. Now, on Mac and PC, you can use the tab key on the keyboard to skip ahead or skip interval. If the interval or workout allows for it, some workout intervals are set to non-skippable, and this won't work in group workouts either. And also note, you won't get the gold star for this interval if you're chasing stars. Now, I use this a lot for my own custom interval sessions to shorten the recovery. Sometimes I need the full 5 minutes, sometimes a minute and a half is just enough. Also note, you can use the action bar for this too, but today it's all about the companion app and that side swipe. Tip number 3, and I call this one, don't be fooled by the progress bar in-game. And once you see this, it's hard to unsee, so I apologize in advance for covering this one. Now, the way in which Zwift shows the interval information on the center display bar can be misleading. In-game, the progress bar is the same color as the interval box, and there's overlap. So, for example, here I am exactly 5 minutes into a 10-minute interval, but on quick visual inspection, it looks like I'm over halfway into the interval. It's not the case. Down to the companion app, and that gives a much better visual indication that I'm only halfway into the interval. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, this doesn't really matter, who cares about this one? I can guarantee you, the end of that progress bar cannot come fast enough in a number of harder intervals, so it is important. Don't be fooled by the misleading progress bar in-game. Tip number 4, and it's all about turning. If you're in workout mode, you can still choose to take different routes at intersections like you can in free ride mode from the companion app. If you switch to the map tab, press the direction you want to go, and then switch back to the workout tab, your workout will not be interrupted whatsoever. For me, I always find it very, very difficult to do big watts in erg mode on a visual downhill, so I'll always steer towards the flats or the climbs than having to put out big watts on descents. And finally, tip number 5 for today, if you're having a good or a bad day, you can adjust your FTP bias in-game by plus or minus 10%, either in the companion app by touching the screen just here, or alternatively, if you do have a keyboard and mouse or a touchscreen, these little arrows also work.
So there we are, 5 tips and tricks for making your experience a little better when using workout mode on Zwift. Now, there is a lot more to it than just these 5. If you're a seasoned Zwifter and didn't know about any of those, please let me know in the comments below. And if I've missed any other tips and tricks that you use in workout mode, let me know in the comments below too. And with that, thanks for watching. As always, give it a thumbs up if you've liked this video and hit subscribe to support this channel. It's much appreciated. We'll see you soon.